All right, everyone. Here we go. All right, hopefully the servers are a little bit better here to actually find someone that's about the same overall as me instead of picking someone who has an abnormally higher overall and kicks my butt. That's what happened the last game. Fucking ridiculous. Okay, we should be good. Alright.
He'll take this up to about the 37. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and eight.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy
playing. Go. Yeah. There we go. Nice run.
11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
I've yet to meet a wide receiver who likes to block more than catching the football, but the best ones understand.
All right.
They'll actually get more passes thrown to them if they help in the run game. Anytime you get a run of that yardage, that means the wide receivers did help. They get down to where a lot of people call the second level.
Jesus, I had to get rid of that thing quick. The guy was right at me.
Put their bodies out there and create more space for their runners to gain the yardage.
They'll give it to him right up the gut.
Yes! Go! Oh!
Nice.
8 yards on the
dang it.
And now they're looking at a third.
That was a good run anyways.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
Oh.
Brady looking to throw on third and two.
Did I get it? Oh my goodness.
Now that's going to be a tough one to explain when they get together to watch the game film, isn't it?
Alright.
Had the out route.
Since it's online, I might have to go for this.
Yet he steps out of bounds that close. Not their best play.
And look at this, they're keeping the punter on the sideline. They're going to go for it here on the opening drive.
20, Alabama, 380.
They'll give it to him right up the gut.
Nice.
3 yard gain, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down.
Ooh, that's taking a real chance on the opening drive of the ball game. I get wanting to be aggressive, but you don't want to leave your defense in a bad spot right away. Fortunately, they're able to convert here on fourth down.
Here's Brady. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. 13.
Nice.
On the pickup, and it'll give the Patriots a first down.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, did a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. They'll run it now out of the gun. And take this one down to about the 23-yard line. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can
pick
up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
To throw is Brady.
Haha, go. Yeah! Nice.
Tommy Bohannon, 23 yards for the touchdown. And the Pats have taken the early lead. And he wasn't blocking or running it there. They tossed it to him.
And remember the good old days when the 49ers corners were riding roughshod in the league. They use their fullback in pass plays.
All right.
Roger Craig, Tom Raffman, those guys were terrific at running these types of plays.
I might have a good play here.
Now here's the first carry for DeMarco Murray.
Yeah.
The encouragement. They stop him at the line of scrimmage on the first play of the afternoon. But at least he was able to break that initial contact, or it could have been a loss.
Yeah, give credit to the defensive player, though. What did he do? Made him slow down, slow up his feet, and allowed the rest of the guys to get there to finish him off.
Here's Mariota, forced out to his left. And his throw is incomplete. Leonard Hankerson, his intended target.
Oops. Picked my play too quick. Darn it.
Incomplete pass on second down. Let's see what the offense draws up.
I don't like that at all.
On third down, Mariota.
Nice.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's
open. Well, he's probably going to go for it since I went for it. The only reason I went for it is because I was so close. He's a little bit far away.
Go here on fourth and ten. They're indeed going. It's Mariota.
Ugh! Dang it! Ugh.
Up of 17 there. And they're able to move the chains as they convert on fourth and long.
He's going for the vertical plays, huh?
So the offense has it first and 10. Mariota on first down.
Nice.
Incomplete. Brian Quick, the intended target. And that'll make it second and 10.
I remember growing up playing basketball. My coach has always talked about communicating on defense, making sure you talk on defense, know where your screens are, know where the cuts are coming from, who has who. But guess what? It's the same thing in football. Even though there's more noise out there, you can hear all the screams of screen, screen. This defense, the bench, everyone let them know what the play was, and that's why they were able to react and knock the ball away.
It'll be a 3-yard gain, and that'll lead here to a 3.
All right.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
7 yards remaining here on third down. Mariota from the gun on third down. This is Johnson, he's got
him. Darn it!
First down yardage before
he...
The 42. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. On first down, Murray. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. And that'll be good for a Tennessee first.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you get a back who's quick and shifty. Can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary, and that led to a really nice game.
For Murray. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. Give him 6 yards on the carry. It's going to be third and three now. And the offense readies for play number 10 of this series.
Now, well, hopefully this might work.
Looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Brief break in the action here.
I keep doing that.
After this. Oh, long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field.
Actually, it might be a good play.
With a dime package here, two extra defensive backs on third. Third and short yardage.
Nope, it wasn't a good play.
And out of bounds, just shy of the end zone.
Oh my god, I keep doing that. God.
Fullback position, but as you and I both know, that doesn't necessarily mean that's a fullback playing in that spot.
So times have changed, and he will take this one in.
Darn it.
Touchdown. Marcus Mariota scoring on the sneak from a yard out, and the Titans are an extra point away from tying this thing up. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Now the Patriots offense, they work their way back out onto the field. That last drive, it was a good mix. Run, pass, defense on their toes.
And what really helps out in a big way is when you're doing the run pass mix and everything's working.
Go.
Side, 30, 20.
Ah.
Down deep into Tennessee territory. A big play there on the catch and run. 63 yards. On first down, they'll run.
Oh, come on. I hate when you get stuck.
And it's second down. Well, there was no blitz. That was just a draw play that, to be frank, didn't fool anybody.
Did we hear the entire stadium screaming draw? Because
they,
it felt like everybody was all
it.
Over that play, and the defense won that battle.
Throwing now is Brady. This will be caught at about the six. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly. And the Titans going to signal for a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so they'll have
two. POW? Huh. Win three tackle battles in offense. Okay. There we go.
The touchdown, but he will have the first down as he's tackled at the two.
Third and one, partner. No need to be fancy there. Just use some force and move forward and pick up the first down.
From the 2 yard line now, it's first and goal. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up.
God dang phone.
Now another timeout here called by the Titans. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. They come out with one back and three tight ends. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he is going to lose yardage here. He'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
Sorry, guys. Someone gave me a call. Man, I hate that. God. It's going to screw my score up here. Darn it. Yeah, there we go. Have to send some pictures. Dang it. Here, I'll do that at halftime.
And that touchdown gives them a touchdown lead before they attempt the extra point. What a great way to end the half.
Yeah, great job to put themselves in front. And now, see on the sideline, special teams defense scrambling, saying we want to preserve this for the final moments of this second.
Well, this is going to suck.
The touchdown, it's Sturgis to send it away. This is taken at his four. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And here comes Tennessee as they get sent to take the field. What do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure if something goes wrong.
Oh, almost intercepted. Almost.
Managing risk is a big decision here.
Second down now after the incompletion. Throwing again, Mariota on second and 10. A right side catch by Crabtree. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Now Mariota. He's going to air one out. And incomplete. A disappointing drop there defensively by the rookie. And now fourth.
Yeah, go for it, bro.
Almost everything right. Excellent coverage, breaks on the football, just unable to haul it in and take it the other way. So he dropped an interception. The key for him now, don't dwell on it. Just move on to the next play.
And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it. On fourth down, they snap it to Mariota.
Oh, I caught it. Darn it.
Down now to 13 seconds.
Oh, he didn't get it. What the freak? Oh, holy crap. Huh. Wow. Okay.
I don't think there's any question about it. You might get a gift of 6 points rather than the 3 that you just noted that you feel like you already...
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone.
By 20! By 20!
Here's Brady.
Yeah!
Patriots. Tommy Bohannon in the final seconds of the first half. And the Patriots add on to their lead.
And that's a lead that excites a team. Good way to finish things off.
Yeah, able to extend that lead, and you always say it, that can totally change the complexion of half number 2.
Yeah, it changes your morale, changes your outlook, but even before that, let's see if they decide to kind of squib kick or what they're going to do on the kickoff, because you don't want to give up a big play right before the half ends.
Good point.
The heck? What did they do?
See as they get set to take the field. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about at the half. Why do anything else?
God dang, I hate when someone wants me to do something, I'm doing something already. It's freaking sucks.
The line of scrimmage, but that's it. And time has run out.
Alright, hold on. Dang it, I can't... I don't want to make this guy wait. Darn it.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Titan offense now as they make their way back onto the field. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there. I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive, and we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is...
I don't know about this.
A play fake to Murray. Now Mariota.
Dang it.
That catch, dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him, and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out, to the sideline, and make a catch.
Mariota now to throw on first down. Going to be taken down deep in
dang it
territory. It's a big play on third down for the Titans. 52 yards. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. They'll try to run it in with Murray, and they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 9. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
One thing I do know about DeMarco Murray, he loves to pile up carries. You know, a lot of backs are concerned about how many they have. Not him. He wants the ball all the time. But so far in this game, that's not working too well, and his team's losing.
He's had a decent chunk of carries. He just hasn't had much success when he's gotten those carries. They're going to hurry back to the line now.
I wouldn't be surprised to see the next step in utilizing this position.
Oh, ho, ho! Ho, ho!
Possession of half number two, and that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive
coordinator. Nice. They felt pretty good about their game. Is the guy gonna quit? Now give me time to your peer has conceded the game. Good. How would you rate the network during it was pretty good. Yeah, I'd say good. That was a good one. But, alright, we got a quitter for my first Ultimate Team recording.